Have you ever wished you could peek inside your favourite tracks to uncover their inner workings? Well, with recent advances in machine learning algorithms, we can. Let me show you my approach to not only peek inside these tracks, but also generate hundreds of synth presets from your favourite songs. I call it sonic sprouting. Sonic sprouting has three stages. Harvesting. This involves collecting and gathering raw sonic elements from existing music or other sources. Foraging. Next, we search for and identify key sonic components within the chosen material. Propagating. Finally, we spread and grow these elements into new, fully developed synth patches. Let's start with harvesting, which is the simplest of the three steps. If you're gathering sounds from sample libraries, Foley, or other sources, you can skip directly to the foraging stage. However, if you're harvesting from existing pieces of music, stem splitting is the method I'd recommend. Demux is a free and open source option for this. Another one is Isotopes RX, if you own it. Since stem splitting became both available and reliable, I've run countless tracks through Demux to uncover the inner workings of my favourite songs. One thing that quickly became apparent is how much simpler a track sounds when broken down into its component pieces. If there's any kind of secret, it lies in how these pieces fit together, not in the individual pieces themselves. Studying tracks via their stems offers a fantastic opportunity for honing your skills, an opportunity that wasn't even possible just a few years ago. Reference tracks are crucial for achieving great mixes, but reference stems allow us to delve even deeper into the nuances that make up those mixes. Once you've obtained your stems, the next step is to import them into your DAW of choice and forage through them for 2-second snippets of material you'd like to sample. These snippets will serve as the reference for generating the patches. So there are some guidelines worth following. For optimal results, look for tonal sounds that sustain in pitch for a couple of seconds and have minimal to no modulation effects. For this video, I deliberately selected an artist known for their complex yet musical sound design, Noisier. These are the samples I chose from their tracks Warhack and The Ascent. Now that we've chosen our samples, we can begin propagating our patches. Simplant 2 is required for this stage. If you don't own Simplant, don't worry, you can grab a 3-week free trial from their website to follow along with this process on your favourite tracks. Simplant 2 is a unique synthesizer. Simplant lets you plant seeds from which branches can be grown and harvested. Its focus is more on sonic discovery than traditional sound design. Simplant 2's Geno Patch feature is the part of the plugin we'll be leveraging. Geno Patch uses machine learning algorithms to analyze our audio samples and generate new patches from them. These patches can range from closely mimicking the original sample to uncovering unexpected surprises. Here's one of the samples loaded into Simplant. If I press the Generate Patches button, you'll see this window populate with 4 strands sprouting upwards. The higher these strands grow, the closer their solutions will be to the original sample. I found that the most interesting patches are actually near the bottom, as they sound least like the original sample. This might sound counterintuitive. Don't we want sounds similar to our source? Sometimes, but often breaking away from the source sparks creativity in exciting ways. By clicking on these dots, we can audition the sounds like so. Once a dot is selected, that sound will be loaded into Simplant for further editing. After selecting a dot, I recommend saving the patch if you like the sound, as closing Simplant will delete everything in the Juno patch window. I've created hundreds of patches following this method that are available free for channel members. In Simplant, patches are called seeds. If I switch to the bulb tab, you'll see what I mean. This is the seed in the middle. By dragging outward, we grow branches from this seed. Each branch offers a different timbre, which changes as we grow it. Closest to the seed, the branches sound identical, but the farther you grow the branch, the more unique it will sound. If you discover a branch you like, you can cut it off and replant it as a new seed. This is similar to resampling a sound back into a sampler for further processing. If this page seems overwhelming, just remember that you don't need to use these controls to generate patches. You can remain on the Juno patch screen for this technique. There is one control I would recommend adjusting, however, and that is the atonality slider. Set it to 0 for a more playable sound. Higher settings introduce atonality and pitch modulation. The benefits of sonic sprouting extend beyond traditional sampling. Instead of directly sampling the original material, we generate new variations based on its sonic attributes. This allows us to edit the genetic makeup of these seeds. If we switch to the DNA editor, you'll find the typical controls on a synthesizer: envelopes, LFOs, oscillators, filters, and effects. Detailed information on each control can be found in the manual. Feel free to pause and read through these screenshots. If you prefer to not sample tracks, you can also import loops and one-shots into Simplant and follow the same process. This allows you to transform almost any sound into a playable instrument within seconds. If you enjoy exploring new sonic possibilities like I do, this approach can be incredibly fun and engaging. Once you've developed a playable patch, the next step is crafting a melody. This is an area where many music producers encounter challenges. Understanding music theory can light the way, but the terminology like triads, minor ninths, inversions, counterpoint, and harmony can seem overwhelming. While learning these definitions is crucial, the real test lies in applying them to create captivating songs. I've endeavored to simplify this process in this tutorial, where I transform two simple chords into a complete song in just 5 minutes. Whether you're a beginner or aiming to refine your skills, this approach to songwriting offers a structured method for composing engaging melodies. I hope you find it valuable. Thank you for watching.